In the previous video, we ended with a primitive memory model, set, reset, and or latch. It can be used to save one bit. To store one or high voltage, you feed it through OR gate. Not only will it pass to the output end, but also it will kick off the other round of OR gate, working as a backup to sustain the high output when input goes away. But there is a problem when passing low voltage input, because the data input and backup input shares the same route to drive the output gate. Typically, the electricity data will fluctuate a few times before it stabilizes. Once a high voltage feedback takes over, low voltage input can no longer flow through. In this video, we're going to improve this simple model. The lessons you'll learn will help you understand more common types of memory models in the future. It's the shared route causing the problem. So we have to break these two. The only possibility is to use the upper gate to pass input when we write data, so that we can write and overwrite as we like. Now the question is how to feed this OR gate in order to pass the input data. Then we need to split into two possible scenarios. Either a low, which has no problem passing, because when low input is enough to hold the output low since it's serial connection. So it doesn't matter what we feed to this OR gate. But if it's high, we need to turn on this OR gate. Its output will help pass this high. So to satisfy both cases, we can simply attach this OR gate to a constant high voltage so that it allows input to pass either a low or high. Now we need to think about how to lock down the data. Since the input might go away, this type of directly connecting input to the output gate has problems, because if input changes, so will the output. So we can't feed input directly. We have to use a logic gate here, isolating the output from the input changes. It works as control. When we turn it on, input is able to pass. But once we turn it off, input will be cut off from affecting output, going into lock mode. Cut off doesn't mean there is nothing here. It simply means that the control gate will provide a constant voltage, regardless of how input changes. How to choose the control gate? It depends on what constant voltage this AND gate needs to maintain the output. The output could be either low or high. The constant voltage has to be supportive of both cases. The only possibility is a high. If you stick a low here, the output will always be low because this is serial connection. So you won't be able to store a high. So we need a high here. What kind of gate can provide you a constant high voltage output when control is off? NAND gate. Because it's serial connection, one transistor non-conducting will fix its output at high because it's connected to the high voltage end naturally. But now the problem is, this constant high we feed to OR gate will enforce a high output under lock mode so that we're not able to store low voltage. This can be easily fixed. We simply connect OR to the control directly. It will turn off OR gate when we lock data. Let's run through cases to see if it works. When we turn it on to write data, input will go through now. But now input will be inverted, so a low becomes a high and vice versa. OR gate will be on to support passing this inverted input. We can simply attach an inverter to the end to flip it back. Let's snap case 1, passing a low input to here. We're focusing only on the crisscross, because if you can make the output from this crisscross stay, you can make the final output stay. When input is high, it will be inverted low. It has no problem passing either. Snap it to here. Now will the output stay when we turn it off? Case 1. When middle input is high, it can not only pass, but also turn down the other transistor of OR gate, working as a backup. When we turn the control off, the high input to the OR gate goes away. But that doesn't matter, because the backup will hold output steady. So let's snap it into here. So first case has no problem. Case 2, for low middle input. When you turn the control off, it will trigger changes to both gates. It's a bit tricky, so let's freeze here to see it more clearly. Upper transistor of the AND gate will switch on. To maintain this low output, we need this lower transistor off. That's why we connect the OR gate to the control, hoping that the control will turn off the OR gate, hence turning off this lower transistor. But here we have a racing problem. This lower transistor needs to be turned off before the upper one turns on. Ideally, if it does, the low output will stay. Let's play back to see what will happen if it doesn't. When the control is off, upper transistor switches on. But if the control signal is not fast enough to turn off the OR gate, then at the moment of transitioning, you will have two transistors conducting at the same time, flipping the output, and it will kick off a loop perpetuating this wrong result. To solve this racing problem, we need a backup low before we turn off the control, meaning that we need to turn off OR gate under write mode. This way, even as upper transistor switches on, the backup is going to sustain the loop. So let's snap it into here. So this OR gate can't be connected to control directly. If we look at these requirements, under lock mode, OR gate needs to sit at low voltage. So we should use an AND gate here, connected to control, so that once the control is off, OR gate is connected to its natural low voltage end. When we turn on the control, OR gate needs to see whatever this AND gate is seeing, suggesting we should connect it to the middle input, because this AND gate will pass whatever it sees, be it high or low. This way, for case 2, high voltage input will pass through as low. This lower AND gate will maintain the same low input to the OR gate, so the backup low is ready. When the control is off, OR gate won't see a change. AND gate will have the upper transistor conducting, but that doesn't matter, because the backup low will keep the loop steady. Now no matter how input changes, output will stay high. For case 1, passing a low input, it will be inverted to high under write mode, turning our OR gate so that it will help pass this high, kicking off the backup, so that once we turn off the control to lock data, AND gate won't see a change. OR gate will see a change from high to low, but it doesn't matter either, because the backup is going to sustain the loop. Now no matter how input changes, output will stay low. Here is the complete circuit using logic gate symbols. This crisscross is at the heart of memory unit. Since there are four types of logic gates, you might wonder, are there any other possibilities? We're going to find out in the next video. It will be more advanced as it deals with a more general way of building memory. You will see why. Out of 16 combos, only a few will work.